My name's Jonathon.
And I'm Jesse.
When we got to City Church, we began to serve, and we didn't know what our place was going to be really in the church. And so we knew one area that we could contribute to the church was through our finances. We trust the church, we buy into the mission. So we made that commitment, not knowing what our lives would look like serving in the church, just knowing that our money would go to changing lives and changing our city.
So when we sat down and realized that we wanted to give to City Church, it really felt impossible because we were really strapped, and we did come from generous parents, and we came from generous families, and you never really saw how they did that. And so we sat down and we talked about it and we looked at everything, and we saw that we weren't giving consistently, even though we had been involved in working in a church. And it's kind of painful to admit that we weren't giving consistently at all. So we decided that we had to do something, and we wanted to be more consistent givers.
A few things that we decided that we need to do was to build a budget. We needed to see where all of our money was going. And Jesse is fantastic at that. She has carried that burden, and every dollar that we make every month is accounted for. And we have to check our spending. And in that is how much that we're gonna give. All the way down, you know, I had to realize painful things, like if you stop at Starbucks every day on your way to work, you're spending $125, $150 a month that we shouldn't have been spending, not just to give to the church, but just for the sake of being smart. So we committed to a budget, and then we committed to getting out of debt, because we believe that will give more freedom. Anyone that's in debt knows of the bondage that it'll put you in, and we're still currently in debt, but we are eliminating that, snowballing it, working to get rid of it so that we have more to give and more freedom for that.
Yeah, when you crack open the shell of money conversations, like whenever we talk about money together, that was one of the hardest things to talk about. We've been married for 8 years, and the first few years money was really tough to talk about. But opening up about money led us to open up about other things to each other. You know, it just kind of, it keeps the door open in your marriage. And so that's really helped us a lot. It's not easy. Like, there's a lot of stuff I want to buy, you know, there's a lot of stuff that we want to do, or something breaks and you've saved up money and it took a long time to save it up and then you got to use it. But we have conversations about it now instead of just it happening, you know, we're prepared as much as we can be.
For somebody who isn't sure where to start, I would tell them just to kind of, you've got to pull the Band-Aid off of it. You have to be willing. If you're scared, if you're strapped for money, you don't feel like that there's any room, this is not just giving to the church. God is going to set you free from other things, but you have to be willing to take that off and look at it, and you have to be willing to take ownership of this. This is where I mishandled my finances. I have wasted this money. How can I begin to change it?
You're always giving, but what are you giving to? You know, and so you've got to know where it's going. And so yeah, I would encourage people just to do it. Just rip the Band-Aid off and be prepared to see, you know, good and bad, and be able to handle it and own up to it.
I think it's important to celebrate,
yeah,
too. Whenever God does something for you, celebrate that. Write it down. Go on a date. We were able to pay off some significant debt.
Yeah.
And we celebrated that. We went and ate dinner. We ate early so we could get lunch specials and save money.
Mm-hmm.
But celebrate those things of God is at work, and He is changing our life, and we're going to be thankful for that. And so we're going to do something to commemorate what He's doing, how He's setting us free. It's important to enjoy the ride along the way.
I agree.